red stockings aren't suffering soon, Detty, then you will be. Do you understand?
Patience, Mom. By the end of today, the villagers will wish they'd never set eyes on Skirty and Noshi.
They'd better. Otherwise, you'll never set eyes on Witch Island again.
How nice to have such an understanding employer.
Shall we proceed?
Oh, yes. Judgment Day cometh, methinks. Go get 'em, cartilage.
Hello? Hello?
What time is it?
11 o'clock.
I'm gonna come back in the morning.
It is morning. What have you been doing? Noshi, you've got a nest in your hand.
Skirty turned me into a tree.
Well,
I fancied an apple.
Just for fun.
Don't know how much that hurts when you pull it off.
You know you're not allowed to do magic.
That's just what Bloater says.
It's what everyone says.
I didn't say it. Noshi, did you say it?
No.
We said we should help Tranters End win the Happy Hamlet competition.
Well, if your spells go monkey, you'll lose it for us.
Well, that's why we've been practicing all night long.
Practice makes perfect.
And we are. Oh,
perfect.
We can do anything.
So now we need to know what we've got to do.
Ah, Ben, there you are. Now I'd like you to run down to the village and round up the contestants for the first stages. Hmm?
But I'm supposed to be doing the shopping.
Are we short of anything?
Everything, apart from cereal, which we've had for breakfast, lunch and dinner every day since Violet left.
The wheaty bits do stick in your teeth.
So I'll leave that to you then, shall I?
Ben, you know, there's nothing I would like better than to potter around Mrs. Tucker's emporium. Ah, but I have to discuss the details of the competition with Mrs. Farmer Barnstorm. What's her name?
Not too early, am I?
Perfect timing, dear lady. Perfect timing. Bye, Ben.
Come on, Mrs. Tucker. This is my best crop ever.
If they were, Ted, they'd be on the supermarket shelves by now.
Look at them, they're perfect. Oh, scrummy. Best apples ever.
I don't want them, because I haven't sold the last lot. People don't buy them.
Why not?
That's why not.
Well, it's not my fault you didn't wash your hands before you came to work.
They were clean, it's from your apple.
Nonsense, they're in perfect health. They've had every fertiliser and pesticide you can think of. DDT, BSE, TNT.
Precisely, Ted. If I washed my hands now, I could set up a chemist from what came off. I can't sell fruit that's covered in chemical slime.
It's because of that competition, isn't it?
No.
It's because my fruit don't say Maidy and Oldie Englandy on it.
What's the problem?
This Happy Hamlet thingy hadn't started yet. And it's ruining my business.
Oh, now, Ted, I'm sure that's not true.
Really? So what's wrong with my top-quality pippins, then, eh? Try that!
No, thank you, Ted. I had one last year and I felt queasy for days. That coating you put on them even melted Harold's dentures.
This is a stitch-up, this is. Just like that vote was.
Now, Ted, I know you weren't happy about the way things turned out.
No, he was fuming.
But now we're actually in the competition, I was rather hoping I might count on some support from you.
Oh, you can, Ben, you can. I should be supporting the Keep Tranters End Modern campaign.
Oh dear. Poor old Ted. Not too happy, is he?
No. But we all have something we're not happy about, don't we?
Still, at least I can count on your support, Polly, Mrs. Tucker.
Oh yes, I'm good old reliable me, aren't I?
Sorry?
Whereas Miss Cartilage is exciting new woman in town.
I'm not quite with you.
No, Ben, and I don't suppose you ever will be.
Here we are. A nice cup of tea.
Polystyrene cups.
Better than paper. No leaks, you know.
Hardly traditional country crockery, Reverend.
Oh, no, it went missing. Not that I'm saying it was stolen or anything. We're a happy little village.
Now, today I'm going to be assessing the village for skills in the traditional arts and crafts.
Oh, yes.
Wool spinning.
Oh, dear.
Stone wall building?
Well...
And roof thatching?
There seems to be a little problem here.
And what's that?
There are no stone walls. Or thatch roofs that I can recall.
And the wool?
Mrs. Tucker stocks colours of all sorts.
So how exactly am I supposed to test you all?
Have you a written exam?
She couldn't have chosen worse things. No one does anything like that here. Maybe she did it on purpose.
I can smell her from here. She's got a whiff of spit-soaked mothballs about her.
I think that's me. Well, I can't smell anything.
Well, you can be the one to keep an eye on her.
To follow her, do you? She's just a competition judge.
Something about her. And Skirty usually spots these things.
Well, forget about college for now. What about this competition?
I think I've got an idea.
Quick, someone's coming.
Mrs. Tucker, is something wrong?
No, just nerves. Nothing more than that.
Well, you're worried about the competition.
No, Ben. I'm absolutely petrified.
Oh, Mrs. Tucker, don't be. It'll all be fine. Really, it will.
I'm feeling better already. I had a little palpitation.
I think we should go in, Mrs. Tucker. We don't want to keep the others waiting.
I reckon Ben's keen on your mum.
I think you could be right.
Right? So what's the big plan?
Don't
tell me. Magic.
Yes, well, I need some help.
Right. A pile of rocks and a wheel to spin, some piles of straw, so we can win.
Stop! How long did you practice for?
I don't know what to say, Reverend.
Ah, Ben, we have a little problem here.
What's wrong?
It seems the village doesn't possess what it takes to compete for the prize, Mr. Babacorn.
Of course, we can thatch and spin and make stone walls with the best of them.
Who can?
Just that we haven't got the facilities to demonstrate our skills.
Well, couldn't we just go on to the next round?
Just start on the village harmonics. That would be most irregular.
Right. But hobbity knob, jibbity tweet, give us the things we need to compete.
That'll be Constable Bloater.
Well, I just hope he can think of a solution.
Yes. Well, we certainly need some help from somewhere.
Ah. There you are, Constable.
Morning, Miss Carthos. Good to see your fulminating presence in our humble village again.
I've just been explaining to Constable Bloater that we haven't the necessaries for stone wall building, thatching. For goodness sake, spinning our own wool.
Which seems a very odd thing to say to me, Reverend.
Why do you say that, Constable Bloater?
Yes, why do you say that, Constable?
Because you clearly arranged the facilities especially for a demonstration.
What?
Yes, over on the village green. Stones, straw and a spinning wheel.
Well, you certainly have an old-fashioned sense of humour, Reverend.
Please, Miss Cartledge, do you think I could have a little time to organise the team for these events? Everyone's so multi-talented, it's difficult to know who to pick for which event.
Very well. I'll return shortly. And I have to say, I'm very much looking forward to seeing you people in action.
Oh, dear.
So, did the witches take the bait?
Hook, line, and sinker.
Good, good, good. Those villagers haven't got a clue what they're doing.
But you want them to win?
Of course, you fool. It's the only way you can get rid of them. But who said winning had to be easy? The harder they try, the more help they need. And the more help they need, the more Skirty and Noshy will cast their spells.
And the more trouble they'll cause.
You're getting there, Detty.
I can see this will be an unmutilated humiliation.
We're still in with a chance.
In half an hour we won't be.
We're good at crafts, just not these.
Look, we'll just give it a go, and at least we can say we've tried and failed.
I don't want to say that.
Mrs. Tucker, I'm going to put you in charge of the spinning wheel.
What?
She doesn't know which end of the cotton to thread through the needle.
Right, Constable, you're on the stone wall. You clearly have some skill in that department.
Right. Everybody ready?
Absolutely. Raring to go.
Well, there we are.
Should use the magic.
Mrs. Tucker, I think you have to do a bit more than just spin the wheel.
I don't think we have a lot of choice.
Ow. Right. This is going to be against the clock, Mrs. Tucker.
It doesn't really matter where you put it. I'm still not going to be very good at it.
I mean, I'm timing you. I want a full spindle of wool, nice and quick.
Oh, dear.
Go on, then. Me? Oh, I was never any good at domestic magic.
I don't know what to do.
Oh, just do it, Noshy. Spirit of the wheel that spins to make, a wool so strong it cannot break. Place your skills in Polly's head and spin to make the fastest thread.
Come on, Mrs. Tucker, you can do it. Come on!
I did it!
Well, it seemed to have inspired her more than I imagined.
Come on, Polly!
Oh, spinning wheel, it's time to race. I'd put the spinner in second place.
Help! Stop! I want to get up!
Oh dear. How unfortunate.
Come on.
How did you get as far as a red stocking? All you had to do was one stupid spell.
Oh, why didn't you do it if you're so clever?
Well, why didn't you put your brakes on? You could have put a speed limit on her.
Well, maybe it wasn't Mrs. Tucker. Maybe you made a useless wheel that just got faster and faster.
Oh, it's all my fault now, is it? Oh, now we're going to get into trouble.
Well, you said we were perfect.
No, I said I was, not you.
Oh, it's only you. At least one thing's going well.
I know what you're up to. I saw you listening, and you've messed it all up.
Push off, bloater.
Yeah, get out of here before we turn you into a pink blancmange.
He already is one.
You've been doing magic, and I'll tell my dad. Unless you do what I say.
Oh, and what's that then, Jim Jams?
Do some more magic.
More?
Ben's chosen Dad to do the wall building. He couldn't stick two pieces of sticky tape together, let alone a bunch of rocks.
Right then, Noshy. Another chance to show what you can do.
Don't worry, Mrs. Abercrombie. Everything here is perfectly rotten.
Don't expect me to be truly unhappy until things are catastrophically calamitous for the little pigs.
Ready as we'll ever be, Miss Cartledge.
Good.
Constable Bloater reporting for action, ma'am.
Very good. And what style of wall building will you be demonstrating, officer?
The stone style.
Generic.
Do I what?
It doesn't matter. Let's just get started, shall we?
About these things.
He's doing it now. Come on.
all.
Do it!
I'm afraid the forces of law and order are not as powerful as they think they are.
Have faith, Harold.
Ben!
Not now, Chris.
Rocks and stones that weigh too much feel so light at Bloater's touch. When he makes a war from you, stick as fast as superglue.
Is that it?
Sounded fine.
It better be.
Congratulations, Constable.
Between you and me, I think I might have had a little bit of help of the abracadabra sort.
You really think so?
Ben, she's around in the village.
What?
Miss Bagmeanly.
Don't be silly, Chris.
I saw her.
Where?
Talking to Miss Cottage.
It's not clever to make up stories, you know, Chris.
But I'm not. I saw her. You believe me, don't you, Ben?
Doesn't sound very likely, I'm afraid.
But I saw her.
But you've been told. Now stop it. Wall of stone just made to stick. Come unstuck when my fingers click. Very impressive, Constable. That should earn you the highest of marks. I've never known a man who could make such an amazing wall just like that. Oh dear. Neil Poin.
Call yourself a witch? The wall just fell apart. You're useless. And you've had it. Push off, Bloater.
You gonna make me?
I don't think it will go down well with the Happy Hamlet competition.
Do you? Forget it. It's not worth the bother anyway. I'm not going to make you pay for making my dad look stupid.
Oh, now look what you've done. He's right, you are useless.
Your stone's not mine.
Well, stop arguing and listen. Miss Cartilage is up to something.
Like what?
She's working with Mrs. Bagmeanly.
Really?
How do you know?
When I followed them, I saw them together. It's true.
Why would she come back here?
Maybe she never really went away.
So what do you think they're up to?
Don't know. But whatever it is, it's bad news for Tranters End.
Oh dear. Not going too well then.
So have you decided to join us?
Nope, I just come here for a good laugh. Cheer me up for not selling my apples.
Well, you won't be disappointed.
What's up next?
Just the thatching to go now.
Oh, my granddad had a thatch roof. Waste of time it was. Can't beat a few good slates.
I don't suppose you learned anything about it yourself, Ted?
Nothing I knew better. Me and my granddad were repairing it all the time.
Ted, you wouldn't consider...
No, I wouldn't.
Not even if you got a quick apple sale out of it. Harold and I really need to stock up the cupboards.
I could let you have half a dozen boxes.
Four, and you do your best thatch.
Done.
And our representative in the thatching section is Farmer Ted Blenkins.
Farmer, are you ready?
Well, first you've got to tell me what you want. An Aylesby tri-ply, a Devonshire double weave, or a 30 cross thatch?
I'll take the cross thatch.
Right.
Maybe it's just someone who looked like Mrs. Bagmeanly.
I'm telling you, I saw her.
Doesn't matter now.
You're not even interested.
Ted's going to do his thatching. Let's see.
Thanks, I thought at least you'd listen to me.
Thank you.
you could do without your help, Noshi.
It depends on your hay pails, doesn't it?
Rooftop hay no more can hold.
There you are. And I doubt you'll find a better thatched roof this side the planet.
Yeah. I'm glad you think so, Farmer Blenkinsop. A nice early start for tomorrow's round. Visual beauty and personal harmony. Goodbye.
It was the witches. They were using magic. They ruined everything.
What do we do? Stay here in Tranters End and get thrown out. Or we could fly high for a while and come back when they calm down. Quick!
I have been quick!
Be quicker then!
Rock glue?
Well, you made the spinning wheel.
But you broke it.
I broke because you made it.
You just know nothing about magic.
Bad work, Detty. I almost feel truly miserable.
I'm glad you disapprove your despicableness. But if you think they're unpopular now, just wait until tomorrow.
Oh.